because the FDA laws multi-brand don't permit us to practice multi-brand retailing. And the telemedicine or the video consultation is just breaking even. So that's the kind of, you know, the summary for this model. In terms of the value proposition that it provides, very quickly speaking, quality healthcare and water, that's a kind of a unique combination being provided for the low-income communities and rural communities. Very powerfully synergistic, leveraging technology. As I mentioned, that technology is a great enabler for this model. Without that, it would not have been possible at all. Our platform for multi-sectoral partnership, both for public sector and private sector, outsourcing a lot of services from public sector, providing a retail opportunity or a semi-retail opportunity for private sector, enhancing the wellness and health quotient for rural communities, directly contributing to reduction in deaths during childbirths and infant mortality rates. Highly responsive to women and children need. More than 60% clients as of today in last 14 months have been women and children. The model is now ready for getting piloted in Philippines and Mexico. We'll be starting that in 3 months from now. And we are actually making efforts to contribute in terms of improving lifestyle for rural communities. This is a typical consumer profile, customer analysis that we have done. Any household which is earning more than 6,000 rupees a month or like $150 and more a month comes into the net of being the customer, which is pretty much 65% of the population in a village. The drivers are, you know, perceived high quality, convenience. For water, it is taste. For, you know, healthcare, it is privacy, access to women doctors. The scope and size of market, without going into a lot of details in that, as of now, it is estimated that more than 4,000 such clinics and 20,000 water points are required in North Indian states alone, which will directly reach out to 100 million people. And this is supported by the fact that as of today, the out-of-pocket expenses constitute almost 70% of spending for consumer healthcare. And out of this 70% out-of-pocket expenses, almost 60% goes towards primary healthcare. That's a compelling 42% of the total spend. And that's a market which we are looking at, especially in North India. In terms of current industry landscape, there are actually not many organizations who provide water and health facilities. So it may not be a kind of a very logical comparison there. But in terms of water, which HealthPoint provides, we equal or exceed in percentage uptake or consumer penetration for each unit that we are currently implementing on ground. In terms of competitors, primarily the informal sector, the quacks and the informal water providers, and also the mindset of people who kind of believe that only urban facilities are high quality. The business model, as I've been explaining till now, it is a combination, it is a for pay, fee for service kind of model with the affordable price points. We are having a multi-service platform, outsourced pharmacy, leveraging social impact capital and public-private financing. We plan to franchise in 2012. Already we have started pilot towards that. We have a very high emphasis on intensive social marketing. And these are the some of the initiatives which are being piloted and planned. Micro health insurance, reference to private sector, specialist consultation for chronic diseases, mother and child health program, and public-private partnership services being outsourced to us. The scalability is that we have cracked the unit economics and we become cash flow positive within 1 year, the entire cluster, the health point and the water point taken together. In terms of organizational profitability, it will be reached by middle of 2013 when we are 175 units strong. We plan to reach to 400 e-health points and 2000 plus water points in next 4 years. In terms of social impact, as most other similar organizations have, we directly promote healthcare, democratizing it. We contribute to Millennium Development Goal 4, 5, 6, and 7. Massive saving for customers. Healthcare seeking knowledge and practice goes up substantially as we have experienced. And direct and downstream employment creation, especially for women. And of course, reduced load on the public sector facility. Just to put some quick numbers here, in next 4 years, we intend to reach out to serving directly 7.5 million users. And it is not excess being created, it is actual users who will be availing water and health services. This also translates potentially into a $27 million saving for each of these, category of people. And this is something which can be potentially used as a disposable income towards a host of other things, including micro health insurance and maybe, you know, lifestyle products and services. This model is directly generating close to 12,000 direct employment in next 4 years, and almost 60% of these will be for women. Coming quickly to the core management team, who have been also the co-founders for this business model, I have my colleague Al Hammond, who is the executive chairman. He has 5 prior startups to his credit, and he has been a co-author with Professor Prahlad for the bottom of pyramid, and also author for the next 4 billion, currently with Ashoka, Innovators for Public. And then I have a co-founder and partner called Chris Dickey, who has been working in health services technology company. And then I got an opportunity to kind of anchor this organization, and I also got an opportunity previously to have a supply chain program across 40,000 villages in India some 10 years back. And then of course also anchored the Nandi and Water Health program, which Sudesh just mentioned a little while ago, which rose to almost 800 villages reaching 5 million people. And Satish, just to quickly say that, you know, Health Point is slated to reach that scale which you were questioning in terms of water. We are on course for that. This is our senior management team. I will just quickly, this is on display right now. People who have come both with national and international experience, high commitment, intent, passion, risk taking, willing to kind of change the contours of rural healthcare and water by implementing a program which may be the best in category. We have a holding company which is the global incorporation, and the operating company which is India. And in next 2 years, we would like to branch out of India as well, and the Indian entity will lead that expansion efforts. In terms of awards and recognition, we have been the finalists at the Piramal Health. The Procter & Gamble announced a partnership with us in last October. And 3 months back, Harvard Business School reached out to us for writing a case study on Health Point, because they feel this is a potential model which can address the inequities in primary healthcare, especially in rural areas across the globe. These are some of the partners, both business and technical partners for us. These are a summary of the financials. We expect to have a revenue of $25 million in next 5 years, with an EBITDA of almost 30%, which is $7 million, and operating profit of almost 13%, which will be like $3 million. We look for a capital requirement of around 5 million this year and total 30 million in next 4 years. And this is primarily for expanding our reach, accelerating the program footprint within India. In terms of critical success factor, and mostly the usual suspects, but very much important for our business as well, retaining the talent, attracting sufficient capital for growth, investments in community mobilization and rural marketing efforts for demand generation, carefully expanding range of services and products that we offer, not to be seen as kind of deviating from our core competence of health and water, partnerships with public sector, because that's a huge facility source support, of course can be counterproductive also, but carefully partnering with them, and of course franchising opportunity, which we see will be a real major driver for expansion. Risk and challenges, change in policy, thereby meaning that free healthcare being made available to all, populist measure being adopted by various state governments, those are like real risk as of today. Competition, continued competition from quacks, deep-rooted consumer preference for reaching out to urban facilities because they feel that's the best in category. And that's a huge challenge that we need to address, because there are not going to be newer doctors in next 5 years being created unless we import them or outsource. And if it is to be outsourced, why not to telemedicine? So to that extent, I believe that Health Point really provides an opportunity for masses to move from a level of despair to everlasting hope. And thank you very much for your time and patience. Is it 8 minutes?
11.
11? So I'll have less of questions.
But can you take us through some unit economics? How much do you invest?
$100. And each water point gives a revenue of around $500. It's a capital intensive or asset heavy, but then we are working on ways and means by more better sourcing and design refinements to kind of bring it down. But then that's the current figures.
What is the typical population it is serving? Is one EHP or one water
point? We call it as EHP cluster, wherein we have one EHP, the e-health point, and 3 to 4 water units. Typically, this will be serving a catchment area of 25,000 to 30,000 people spread over 4 to 5 villages, which are like linked to each other.
What's the time frame within which an individual EHP breaks even at an operating level?
Sandeep, that's one of the most important questions that I would have expected. When we started this model, it was a standalone EHP model, and there were no water units as clusters. And to that extent, our experience was that it was almost not just getting break-even, right? And the moment we have shifted to a cluster strategy, it is now getting to break-even within 6 months, 8 months, not more than that, even the newer units. And that has also given us opportunity to kind of attract traffic or customers from these satellite villages. And also, these are such villages where no other water operating and nobody wants to go to a village of 4,000 population. So this gives us a unique opportunity to kind of service those villages as well.
So are you, in essence, using water as a marketing strategy in effect for the e-health point?
It is not the marketing strategy, it is part of the marketing strategy.
So could you talk a little bit more about the marketing strategy and how you actually...
Okay.
Because you talked about the community health factors, etc. So maybe just talk a little bit about that.
Right. So what we do before setting up any health point cluster, we do a feasibility study, which is, you know, a combination of both technical for water as well as for health in terms of technology. And also the socioeconomic feasibility component, which comprises, you know, generally the competition, if at all in any form, the willingness, the price sensitivity for people, willingness to pay, current spending patterns and all that. And then based on that, then we dot the entire district and then see how many health points potentially can be created there. Once it is clear, then we reach out to the district administration or the village community and then present the entire model to them and also give them an opportunity to visit the existing, you know, other facilities like that. And then we get a clearance from them, enter into a long-term lease of 15 years for setting this up, and thereafter all expenses are, you know, on our account. So to that extent, we employ safe water promoters and health coordinators, which are generally from the local area. And we rely heavily on interpersonal communication, the local media and the outdoor media, for raising the awareness of people and then making attempt to convert it into knowledge and practice for reaching out to health services. Water definitely is a main component, but water not as a commodity, but more as a health platform. And then actual quality health, which is currently not being provided in the immediate local vicinity. So those are like components of our marketing strategy as of today.
How many of these are operational?
Currently, 9 health points and 25 water points.
One question on your international plan. If you could comment about the timing and about the risk of distraction from the huge task of developing the EPA.
The timeline that we see is starting pilots in Philippines in July this year. And we have entered into a joint venture agreement with a leading corporate organization in Philippines. And this will be directly seen by the holding company based out of US. And in terms of distraction, well, I must admit that other than my time, none of the other Indian team's time will be provided. So my time...
The CEO, that would be distracted.
Yeah.
So, stay.
Yeah, so that's your honest admission on my part, and we are still figuring it out. That's where somewhere the pilot got delayed by 4 months.
Why this urge of going international? I don't understand. Why do you think it adds value to the company, whereas it can derail, distract resources?
Actually, it's a huge market. So when you ask that, this gives me a lot of relief. I'll make you meet my boss, because I have been talking to him exactly the same thing. India is 28 countries woven into one. But then, on the other hand, what we see is that there is an opportunity in Philippines as well, and there is a willing partner there. And conditions are almost similar as in rural and peri-urban India. So we would like to expand at least in one country as of now. And Ashoka is willing to support us more in that country because of the Ashoka network that they have there, Fellows network.
Right, so but the financing you're talking about would be for...
Only India. As I said, that is a JV, and then we will be leveraging financing separately for that as a separate P&L.
So the question I have is, you talk about raising $30 million and then getting to $25 million in revenue. How do you explain that math to investors?
As of now, $25 million revenue will be the 2015 revenue. As a run-up to that, we'll have around $65 million in revenue during the course. And then this $30 million is also being raised in next 4 to 5 years. And as I said, it's a bit asset-heavy as of today. But we are finding novel financing patterns, especially with the public-private partnership, wherein the entire cost of, you know, setting up this as a building infrastructure is taken care by government increasingly. So that way the capital cost requirement becomes